Now, for today, we are going to take up a very simple and straightforward scenario for commercial real estate. Essentially, we are going to calculate net operating income for a commercial property. And in the equation, we're going to have some revenue line items and some expense line items. And we're going to see how to pass on some of the values to the Power BI model and also calculate some of the intermediate KPIs and finally subtract expenses from revenue so that we arrive at net operating income. And we're also going to make certain assumptions. For example, they're going to look at a five-year horizon for the purposes of our modeling and so forth. And the reason why I've taken a very simplistic scenario is that I'm mainly interested in showing you or get a feel of how you can utilize Power BI to start building models. And don't worry, you don't have to write extensive lines of code. You don't have to write any line of code at all. Now, we all know how a spreadsheet model looks like. And once I have a model, I'm going to have net operating income and then revenue items and then expense items. I'm going to come up with my own assumptions and I will project it for 5 years. And let's say I want to change an assumption for 2023. I'll go and make some changes in the cell and the net operating income is going to get updated automatically, right? But a lot of times this is not very visual. And let's say when you're making a lot of changes, it's not much easy to understand what impacted the outcome mostly, right? And it's also much harder to compare two or three different scenarios. But not only that, right? Even simple visualization is much harder. So today we are going to look at how to leverage something like Microsoft Power BI to build out something like this. And in a couple of minutes, I'm first going to give you spend about 5 minutes on a live demo. I'm going to show you in the finished product how it's going to look like. And then I'm going to walk you through how you can construct this step by step. But since we're going to have only 15, 20 minutes, I won't be able to cover all of them. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you some resources. So one is the Microsoft Power BI desktop software, which is free. And you can also download this resource pack, which is going to have a step-by-step tutorial. You will have the raw data, the license key for ValQ, and also the final and completed demo file. And you can use this to build out our model step by step. And if you feel I'm rushing it a little bit today's session, don't worry. In fact, I'll quickly show you how the training material is going to look like. It's about some 48 pages, but not to worry, it has a lot of images. So it's a step-by-step tutorial, and it's going to explain you a lot more in detail on how to build the model that I'm going to be covering in the session today. So imagine doing something like this. I just showed you the spreadsheet model, but see how intuitive this is, right? We have a net operating income and it's broken down into gross revenue and expenses. And when I expand gross revenue, it's going to have its own line items. And then I can click and scroll, drag around. And then the expenses is going to be broken down into its own constituent elements. And then expand real estate taxes. So I can navigate this in more like a tree-like fashion. And not only that, right? So let's say that we are going to change our assumption that our potential gross income is going to increase because of demand. All I need to do is, and just observe that currently the net operating income for the current year is close to $800,000. But as I go here and then I can start simulating, drag the slider around and then simulate values for my net, for my potential revenue, right? And let's say I'm increasing it by 18%. And as soon as I release the mouse button, right, it's automatically going to update my effective gross revenue as well as operating income, right? So you're able to do simulations at the click of a button. Similarly, if I increase my or decrease my vacancy rate because there is a lot of demand, and both of these changes is going to be impacting the final outcome. And when I click on the net operating income finally, it's going to show me how it changed for the current year. And I can also change it across all the years, but I'll show that later. But essentially, here it'll tell me, you know, what were our original projections, and then how much of the change was brought over because of changes to the potential gross income, and how much change was came through because of the change in vacancy rate. And because these factors also influence each other, there is also a component impact or a small portion which is unexplained, right? And you don't have to do anything, right? There is no magic. And I'm going to show you how to build this from the scratch. And not only that, so we made a couple of changes here, right? And then you know that, you know, we are actually working only on the baseline scenario. So let's say you want to create a couple of other scenarios on the fly. Now with ValQ, I can go here and create a new scenario with no changes, or I can select an existing scenario and then go and say that, hey, you know, I want to copy the scenario, right? So let's go back to scenario one, and then I'm going to change something else. You know, maybe our expense reimbursements, maybe our insurance rates, let's say it increases to 5%. And I can toggle between all these scenarios at the click of a button, right? Imagine how long it's going to take in Excel. And finally, I can click on this compare scenarios. I can choose all the scenarios that I just created and then compare them at the click of a button, right? And just remember, right, I created these right in front of your eyes. So ValQ can deliver a lot of productivity when it comes to financial modeling. But let me stop here in the interest of time. I'm going to switch to Microsoft Power BI and show you how you can build this model from scratch.